Assalamu alaikum students, here is Usama Tahir and you're watching Learn English with Usama Tahir. Students, we were discussing about an apology for poetry by Philip Sidney and I have explained everything with respect to its introduction in my previous lecture. You can consult there. Today we are going to talk about its second section. And in the second section, Philip Sidney refutes four arguments that were given by Stephen Gosson against poetry. So he rejects those arguments and leveled up against Stephen Gosson and again favors the poetry. So the very first argument that was given by Stephen Gosson was poetry is unprofitable. It was said by Stephen Gosson, and all those four arguments were given in the essay by Stephen Gosson, The Abuse of Poetry. There was the essay name. So the poetry is unprofitable. It was said by Stephen Gosson, and what Philip Sidney says in the response of it is that poetry is not unprofitable. Poetry is profitable. Stephen Gosson says that you can do anything else instead of poetry because it's wastage of time. But Philip Sidney says no. Poetry is not the wastage of time, and poetry helps you to learn new and new things because it is the mother of, it is the mother of the new knowledges, and you can say it does not only teach you but also makes you happy and you learn new and new things. So how come it can be the wastage of time, right? So this argument was refuted with these statements that poetry is superior than history and philosophy, and you learn about life and you learn about the civilizations and new things, and it makes you virtuous, it makes you a good person. So how can be it is useless? It is useful, it is profitable, it is going to make you a good person, it teaches you and it makes you happy. Next argument was raised that poetry is the mother of lie. So Stephen Gosson says that poetry is the mother of lie, but Philip Sidney says that poetry never affirms anything to be true. So how can it be a lie, right? And poet never says that their poems are true, right? They said their poems are real, like their poems are like sometimes imagination, sometimes are real like, but never claims to be true. So you cannot say that poets are liars. So poet never states something to be true. So how can it be a lie? And similarly, poets never deliberately speaks or writes down the lie. It's just they just imagine new things and make them feel real. So they never claim this to be true. So how can you object poetry to be a lie, right? And next one is poetry leads to sinful behavior. So it is totally wrong in the eye of Philip Sidney, because he considered poetry to be noble and holy and of divine nature, and he says that poetry leads to virtuous behavior instead of sinful behavior. Yeah, he says that the abuse of poetry, the misuse of poetry, can lead to sinful behavior or the corruption, but the actual poetry itself is not going to lead you to the wrong path. It's not going to make you a bad person, but it will going to make you a good person. It will lead human beings to the virtuous behavior. So the fourth one argument is Plato kicked the poets from his republic. He claims that poetry was that much bad, poetry was that much useless, that Plato himself kicked poets from the republic. So Philip Sidney disagrees with the statement altogether, and he says that no, it is the wrong poets that were kicked by the Plato and not the poetry itself, because Plato himself was poetic in his writing and he gained so much knowledge from poetry, and he says that poetry is divine and poetry elevates soul and not something that you should be saying that corrupt or wrong. So this is the use of poetry that can be good or bad, but poetry itself is not bad. Poetry is noble, poetry is useful, poetry is profitable, poetry is the mother of all the knowledges, and it makes you happy and it teaches you all of the things. So these were arguments and views of Philip Sidney. This was all today. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.